So far, we've described the address translation process like this. The offset from the virtual address simply gets copied to the physical address, and in order to translate the virtual page number, we do a lookup in the page table, which is in memory, to find the physical page frame. Now you may be asking yourself, won't going to memory for the page table every time we access a memory address be slow? In fact, we'll have to go multiple times for a hierarchical page table? Well, indeed it would be. Thankfully, the page tables themselves may end up in our cache, which can help considerably. But architects have also created a special purpose cache for storing page table entries called the Table Lookaside Buffer, or TLB for short. Instead of going through these slower traditional memory mechanisms, we're taking a special shortcut. Whereas the caches we talked about earlier are usually indexed by physical address, the TLB is indexed by virtual address. After all, its job is to translate virtual page numbers to physical ones. This is extra tricky because one virtual page number may be mapped to a physical address in one process, but it might be invalid in another or mapped to a different location. There are two ways to handle this problem. Some systems simply flush the TLB on every context switch, that is, every time the address space switches. This is a main reason that context switches are considered so costly. Alternatively, the TLB can use an address space identifier field in the table to make sure that the translation in the table is meant for use in the current context. I should point out, too, that the kernel sometimes gets special treatment in the TLB. Because the kernel addresses are constant across processes, there's no need to flush them from the TLB on a context switch. Sometimes, too, part of the TLB is reserved for kernel addresses.